Thank you.
Hi everyone. Today I'm going to talk about my presentation, my PhD introductory seminar. So first of all, the project title is Tree Nutrient Availability and Fruit Quality in Sweet Cherry and Apple as well. Now I would like to present brief background information. So it has long been recognized that soil fertility influences the qualities of agricultural crops produced. And in the early of 19th century, it was also recognized that soil fertility depends on total available nutrient. And however, it's not relies on the amount of total nutrient had been fixed in the soil. So studies describe that definition of soil fertility could be defined as the soil's ability of maintain biological productivity and the environment quality of soil, and also promoting plant and health, promoting and plant and animal health. And also studies indicated to achieve that it may only by following the integration of biological and chemical fertilizer system. Before talking about fertilizer system, can be divided into three types according to the agriculture type of agriculture system. So experts and interested people divided the farms into three types: biological and conventional farms. And in this farm, they use chemical fertilizer to fertilize plant, and also use herbicide to control weed and pathogen. The second type of agriculture systems, biological farms. And biological farm can be divided into two types: and organic farms and biodynamic farms. But some studies state the biodynamic farm is one part of organic farms. And in this system, they use the animal residues and plant residues to fertilize the plant, and the farmers, they avoid to use chemical fertilizer. And also they use some microbes to control other pathogen. The third one, integrate system, which is combining all three agriculture systems. So the application of bioproducts impacts on quality of soil, and also when plant residues or any organic fertilizer enhancing soil structure and soil fertility. Some studies claim that the biological farms has some deficiencies if applied alone. So they said organic farms could be producing half the yield of conventional system because they avoid to use most minerals, and also maybe increase weed and pathogen. As I said, the biological farms has some disadvantage. Also, the conventional farm has some advantage. So the continue of using herbicide and chemical fertilizer, it may lead to potential decline of soil structure, and also decline in soil fertility and elimination of soil biota, just as microbes and fungi. So those microbes have the symbiotic relationship between them and the plants, And mycorrhiza fungi has a lot of advantages to plant. So mycorrhiza have the ability to break down the proteins or amino acid. And also it can convert nitrogen and phosphorus compounds to soluble forms. And also it can increase protection from pathogen by producing antibiotics. And also mycorrhiza fungi can produce many plant hormones and expand the surface area of plant roots, as it's shown in these two figures. And in contrast, plant provide mycorrhiza fungi with carbohydrates. So, integrated farming system, it may only one optimal solution to solve all disadvantages which we will get from conventional farming and biological farms. So integrated farming system can be helping to produce rising production cost and also soil degradation and the negative environmental impact from pesticide. Regional Detail, they conducted a trial to investigate the impacts of agriculture management practice on soil and on soil quality and apple production. So the authors used the compost and foliar sprays and bark mullers, and they are using mowing was used for weed control, and they use fruit thinning was by hand, and for pest management used Bacillus thuringiensis, and also they control codling. They use Bacillus thuringiensis, and also the author they used normal chemical fertilizer and chemical fruit training, and they use foliar spray and pesticide to control weeds and pathogen as a conventional systems. So the result shown. Accommodate water entry and resist surface structure degradation. Have low rating compared with other soil quality functional by using conventional systems. And also total quality function, the organic and integrated system, they have a little bit significant differences between them and conventional system. Research project: the aim of this project to investigate the impact of biofertilizer and chemical fertilizer and effective microbes on soil biology and soil biology and nutrient availability and crop growth, yield and quality. Significancy and application of the research to determine the quantities of fertilizer for each type of soil under the study. And also the impact of different fertilizer added on the availability of a nutrient in the soil, and also to look for the biodiversity in the soil and its impact on the quality and the productivity of cherry and apple fruits through the influences of the transfer of nutrients in the soil. Also improving the consistency and the quality of cherries fruit to by improving soil fertility and also to reduce the environmental pollution. Research methodology. Field trial established as part of existing TIA research project in cherries and National PIPS Apple program are being used in this study. Labs tests, soil and leaf nutrient tests will be undertaken annually, and mycorrhiza fungi diversity and drought colonization will be examined throughout the life of the project. So the result will be used to determine the level of essential nutrient for each soil, and also use the result to determine the amount of the amount and type of fertilizer to be applied for each treatment. Cropping measurement. Tree growth will be measured each year by measuring trunk circumference. Tree productivity under the influences of biochemical fertilizer and effective microbes, and also integrate among tree application will be assessed by measuring yield. After harvest, fruit quality will be assessed, including weight, fruit number and size, and color, firmness, sugar contact, and acidity. Glasshouse trials set up to study the effects of organic compounds and effective microbes on plant growth and nutrient release and mineralization. Research design. The trial set up as a split plot design with four replicates of each soil treatment applied to multi-trees plots. Plot size for the main plots is 10 trees, and main plots divided into two sub-plots, 5 trees, to examine efficiency of effective microbes. A glasshouse trial set up as 3 × 3 × 2 factorial and randomized complete block. Three level of organic compounds and 3 level of liquid fertilizer and two level of effective microbes for replicate. Acknowledgement. Thanks to my supervisor, Dr. Sally Bound and Dr. Douglas Close and Dr. Nigel Swart, their countless support. And I owe many thanks to Mr. Stephen Peterson and Mr. Justin Darien and Dr. Ken Berry and Dr. Alyssa Gracie. Thanks for listening.